Hello everyone, a very warm welcome to all of you in today's session from your presenter Narinder Kaur. Dear students, I hope all of you are in best health. Today we are going to read Don't Quit, a motivational poem. We will do part 2 of this poem. Let's get started. Don't Quit, Part 2. Let us learn something about the poet. Edgar A. Guest was a British-born American poet who became known as the People's Poet. His poems often had an inspirational and optimistic view of everyday life. His famous works are Home Rhymes, The Panama Canal, A Heap of Living, Just Glad Things, Just Folks, Over Here, Poems of Patriotism, etc. Dear students, Edgar Albert Guest is the poet of the poem Don't Quit. Let us read the poem Don't Quit. When things go wrong, as they sometimes will, when the road you are trudging seems all uphill, when the funds are low and the debts are high, and you want to smile but you have to sigh, when care is pressing you down a bit, rest if you must, but don't you quit. Dear students, let us read the stanza once again. When things go wrong, as they sometimes will, when the road you are trudging seems all uphill, when the funds are low and the debts are high, and you want to smile but you have to sigh, when care is pressing you down a bit, rest if you must, but don't you quit. Life is queer with its twists and turns, as every one of us sometimes learns, and many a failure turns about when he might have won had he stuck it out. Don't give up though the pace seems slow, you may succeed with another blow. Often the goal is nearer than it seems to a faint and faltering man. Often the struggler has given up when he might have captured the victor's cup, and he learned too late when the night came down how close he was to the golden crown. Success is failure turned inside out. The silver tint of the clouds of doubt, and you never can tell just how close you are. It may be near when it seems afar, so stick to the fight when you are hardest hit. It's when things seem worst that you must not quit. It's when things seem worst that you must not quit. Dear students, let us narrate the following stanza in our own words. When things go wrong, as they sometimes will, when the road you are trudging seems all uphill, when the funds are low and the debts are high, and you want to smile but you have to sigh, when care is pressing you down a bit, rest if you must, but don't you quit. Let us summarize the stanza. In these lines, the poet wants to say that while pursuing your goal, it may happen sometime that you feel everything is going wrong and not according to your wish. The track you are following is getting difficult to be followed. Your resources are not adequate. Pains and worries are dragging you downwards. You should rest at that time, but never quit. Never think of giving up. Just continue to follow your dream. Narrate the following stanza in your own words. Don't give up though the pace seems slow. You may succeed with another blow. Often the goal is nearer than it seems to a faint and faltering man. Dear students, let us summarize this stanza. The poet says that one should move continuously towards the goal when if his or her speed is slow. Steadiness is essential. One more attempt can lead the person to his desired destination. It happens that the person in his own worries cannot see that his goal is nearer and his hard work is going to be rewarded. Narrate the following stanza in your own words. Often the struggler has given up when he might have captured the victor's cup, and he learned too late when the night came down how close he was to the golden crown. Success is failure turned inside out. Summary. Mostly it happens that the people quit when they were the nearest to the destination, and when he comes to know, it becomes too late. His golden crown has slipped from his hands, and his upcoming success turns into failure. So, don't quit. Dear students, let us do some post-reading activities. Learning the language. Formation of comparative and superlative degrees. An adjective is a word which qualifies a noun or a pronoun. In other words, an adjective adds something to the meaning of a noun or a pronoun. Examples: a black horse, some money, 30 books, this noble man, a clever boy. Here, black, some, 30, noble, clever are adjectives as they are adding something to the meaning of a noun. Here are some more adjectives: blossoming trees, snowy field, straight hair. Dear students, there are a few types of adjectives. Type 1. Most adjectives generally form the comparative degree by suffixing er, and the superlative degree by adding the suffix est. Please look at the following tables. Degrees of comparison, comparatives and superlatives. Strong, stronger, strongest. Positive, comparative and superlative. Noble, nobler, noblest. Near, nearer, nearest. Able, abler, ablest. Sane, saner, sanest. Clean, cleaner, cleanest. Dear, dearer, dearest. Bright, brighter, brightest. Bold, bolder, boldest. Clever, cleverer, cleverest. Short, shorter, shortest. Deep, deeper, deepest. Let us do some more words. tall, taller, tallest. Few, fewer, fewest. Fast, faster, fastest. Great, greater, greatest. Hard, harder, hardest. High, higher, highest. Keen, keener, keenest. Kind, kinder, kindest. Light, lighter, lightest. Strong, stronger, strongest. Weak, weaker, weakest. Poor, poorer, poorest. Rare, rarer, rarest. Pure, purer, purest. Rich, richer, richest. Safe, safer, safest. Sweet, sweeter, sweetest. Type 2. In the case of longer adjectives of 3 or more syllables, comparative and superlative degrees are formed by adding the word more and most, not er or est, more and most, before the positive degree. Look at the following tables. Beautiful, comparative will be more beautiful, not beautifuler. It will be more beautiful, and superlative will be most beautiful. Courageous, more courageous, most courageous. Brilliant, more brilliant, most brilliant. Capable, more capable, most capable. Wonderful, more wonderful, most wonderful. Ignorant, more ignorant, most ignorant. Diligent, more diligent, most diligent. Difficult, more difficult, most difficult. Interesting, more interesting, most interesting. Let us do it once again. Beautiful, more beautiful, most beautiful. Courageous, more courageous, most courageous. Brilliant, more brilliant, most brilliant. Capable, more capable, most capable. Wonderful, more wonderful, most wonderful. Ignorant, more ignorant, most ignorant. Diligent, more diligent, most diligent. Difficult, more difficult, most difficult. Interesting, more interesting, most interesting. Type 3. Adjectives of 2 syllables follow one or the other of the above rules. Those ending in ful, er, ve usually take more and most. Let us look at the examples. Active, ending with ve, active. More active, most active. Doubtful, more doubtful, most doubtful. Careful, more careful, most careful. Harmful, more harmful, most harmful. Proper, more proper, most proper. Obscure, more obscure, most obscure. Secure, more secure, most secure. Let us look at the words. Active, ending with VE. Doubtful, ending in FUL. Careful, ending in FUL. Harmful, ending in FUL. Proper, ending in ER. Obscure, ending in RE. Secure, ending in RE. Let us read once again. Active, more active, most active. Doubtful, more doubtful, most doubtful. Careful, more careful, most careful. Harmful, more harmful, most harmful. Proper, more proper, most proper. Obscure, more obscure, most obscure. Secure, more secure, most secure. Type 4. Those ending in Y or LY are IER and IEST after the removal of Y. Pretty, prettier, prettiest. Y has been removed and Y has been replaced by IER, IEST. Pretty, prettier, prettiest. Happy, happier, happiest. Heavy, heavier, heaviest. Easy, easier, easiest. Jolly, jollier, jolliest. Busy, busier, busiest. Holy, holier, holiest. Type 5. When a consonant comes after a short vowel sound, it doubles itself and adds ER and EST in comparative and superlative forms. Big, bigger, biggest. G has been doubled. Big, bigger, biggest. Hot, hotter, hottest. Fat, fatter, fattest. Sad, sadder, saddest. Wet, wetter, wettest. Thin, thinner, thinnest. Red, redder, reddest. Mad, madder, maddest. Let us read once again. Big, bigger, biggest. Hot, hotter, hottest. Fat, fatter, fattest. Sad, sadder, saddest. Wet, wetter, wettest. Thin, thinner, thinnest. Red, redder, reddest. Mad, madder, maddest. Type 6. Miscellaneous adjectives. These are irregular adjectives. Bad, worse, worst. Far, farther, farthest. Good, better, best. Late, latter, latest. Little, less, least. Low, lower, lowest. Much, more, most. Old, older, oldest. Or you can say old, elder, eldest. Up, upper, uppermost or upmost. Dear students, let us do a post-reading activity. Fill in the blanks with appropriate degree of the adjectives given in the brackets. He is a dash student. The Taj is a dash building. My table is the dash of all. Her sweatshirt is dash than her jeans. Tina's hair is dash than Lena's hair. He is a tall student. The Taj is a beautiful building. My table is the biggest of all. Her sweatshirt is softer than her jeans. Tina's hair is longer than Lena's hair. Soumya is dash than Vijaya. Haridwar is one of the dash places for the Hindus. Gold is dash than silver. Ravinder is dash than Parul. This is the dash book I have ever read. Soumya is funnier than Vijaya. Haridwar is one of the holiest places for the Hindus. Gold is more expensive than silver. Ravinder is smarter than Parul. This is the best book I have ever read. The comparative degree should be used only when there is some comparison, like this book is better than the other. Comparatives ending in OR or ER are followed by TO. I am senior to him. He prefers health to wealth. Use of double comparatives and superlatives should be avoided. This is incorrect. He is more abler. More abler is incorrect than his brother. The correct sentence will be, he is abler than his brother. Let us make comparative forms of the word given in the brackets by adding ER or more to it. Cats are dash affectionate than gods. Sheena is dash old than Gagan. China is large than Poland. My Hindi class is dash boring than my maths class. In the UK, the streets are generally dash narrow than in the USA. Delhi is dash busy than Chandigarh. Jyoti is dash quiet than her sister. Kiran is dash ambitious than her brother. My garden is a lot dash colorful than this park. My house is a bit dash comfortable than a hotel. Cats are more affectionate than gods. Sheena is older than Gagan. China is larger than Poland. My Hindi class is more boring than my math class. In the UK, the streets are generally narrower than in the USA. Delhi is busier than Chandigarh. Jyoti is quieter than her sister. Kiran is more ambitious than her brother. My garden is a lot more colorful than this park. My house is a bit more comfortable than a hotel. Dear students, now here is the time for your home assignment. This is your home assignment 1. Fill in the blanks with the suitable degree of comparison. My room is dash big than yours. Ravi is dash polite than Sunny. My sister is dash tall than me. An ounce is dash little than a pound. Fifth sentence. Sachin's score is dash good than Sehwag's. The earth is dash large than the moon. A rose is dash beautiful than a marigold. The Arctic Ocean is dash cold than the Indian Ocean. This is your home assignment 2. Pick out the adjectives. Sonu is a dishonest man. You need to pick out the adjective from this sentence. Dolly is 6 years old. There is little hope of her survival. How many marks have you got? This is our school. I washed him with my own eyes. Those flowers are beautiful. It seems to a faint and faltering man when he might have captured the victor's cup. How close he was to the golden crown. the silver tint of the clouds of doubt. So stick to the fight when you are hardest hit. Let's read once again. It seems to a faint and faltering man, when he might have captured the victor's cup, how close he was to the golden crown, the silver tint of the clouds of doubt. So stick to the fight when you are hardest hit. Thank you. That's all for the day. Your presenter, Narinder Kaur, working as English mistress at Government Middle School, Anandpur, District Fatehgarh Sahib, Punjab. It is an initiative by Department of School Education, Punjab. Have a nice day.